the name of Allah, our Creator, the Creator of the universe and of everything that's in it, I greet you all, our dear viewers, in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, blessings, and mercy be with you all. This episode, we are trying to discuss the science of the last hour in Qur'an and Sunnah. Of course, the last hour is 100% in the domain of the unseen. Nobody knows anything about it. But the Qur'an tells us some of the major events that are going to take place during this last hour. Of course, the last hour is the last phase in the current history of the earth and the universe. We can judge these events in the light of what's going on today. But after that, we'll have the creation of a different earth. After the structure of that universe, we will have the creation of an earth other than ours. And this new earth has to be much larger than the current earth to accommodate the billions of human beings that are currently living today, the billions that lived and passed away from the days of Adam and Eve, may Allah be pleased with them both, and the billions of individuals that will come after us until the end of this world. So the new earth has to be much greater, much bigger, much larger. And it will also include every single atom of the current earth, because we will be resurrected from our remnants in that earth. The Quran says, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. The day will come when another earth will be created instead of the current one, and other firmaments will be created other than the ones that are surrounding us today. The Quran speaks about the last hour, the day of resurrection and judgment, and then the afterlife, the eternal life, the other life, which will come after the day of judgment. These three phases happen so swiftly, so quickly, that you cannot easily discriminate between them. But the Quran has precisely defined these three phases: the last hour, the day of resurrection and accountability and judgment, and eternity in the life to come. Unless Allah has told us about these stages in the future of our existence, there is no way that man, whatever intelligent he or she may be, can interpret what's after death, what comes after this life. In Islam, we are taught that there is an accountability, a phase of accountability in the grave. Then there will be a resurrection from the new earth, then judgment, then eternity in life to come. Both the Quran and the Sunnah have described the events, the major events that will take place in the last hour. We cannot talk about the accountability in the grave, how it's going to be, or on the day of judgment, or in the eternity in the world to come. These are 100% in the domain of the unseen. And unless the Quran and the Sunnah have told us something about these major events, we could have never known anything about it. And the description of the last hour in Quran and Sunnah lies amidst the very important scientific notions in these two major Islamic sources. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said, من سره أن ينظر إلى الآخرة كأنه رأي العين فليقرأ إذا الشمس كورت إذا سماء فطرت إذا سماء شقت. This unlettered prophet, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said, whoever would like to look at the last hour as if he is seeing it with his own eyes, he has to read these three surahs of the Quran, surah number 81, 82, and 84. Surah At-Takwir, the winding up, or the sphericity, the folding up, or the sphericity. Surah Al-Infitar, the cleaving asunder, the splitting of the firmament. Surah Al-Inshiqaq, Surah 84, the rendering asunder. This means that the firmament, which is very closely knitted and bound together today, is going to be broken asunder. So these three surahs can tell us exactly what is going to happen during the last hour, during the destruction of the existing universe. We read in Surah At-Takwir, Surah number 81, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ, when the sun is wound round. And one would question, isn't the sun a spherical body today? Actually, we see the sun a perfect sphere from our stand on Earth. But if we realize that the distance between the Earth and the sun is in the range of 150 million kilometers, this means that we cannot see the sun in its proper dimensions. Some spacecrafts were sent to photograph the sun from a closer distance, and it showed ramifications of the various arms shooting out from the sun for distances that can be several tens of thousands of kilometers long. So currently, the sun is not a perfect sphere. The fact that these solar radiations, the solar eminences, are coming out from within the sun, goes back to the fact that the sun is a huge nuclear furnace within which a process of nuclear fusion is taking place. And as a result of that nuclear fusion, immense quantities of heat are generated. And actually, the sun is boiling. The core of the sun is under a temperature of around 15 million degrees centigrade. The eminences coming from the sun can carry a temperature of 1 million to 2 million degrees centigrade. The outer surface of the sun is around 6,000 degrees centigrade. So actually, the sun is boiling. And as a result of that boiling, we have these prominences, these huge prominences. What will happen when the nuclear fusion within the sun starts to die out gradually? This is exactly what the Quran describes. These prominences will be withdrawn within the sun, and the sun will start to cool down and will take its perfect spherical shape. And that's why I dare say that this simple notion at the beginning of Surah At-Takwir, the Surah number 81 in the glorious Quran, is one of the greatest scientific notions in this noble book that can testify to the fact that this book cannot be the work of man. It's the divine word and its divine purity, because at the time of revelation of this surah or of that book, nobody on earth knew anything about the huge solar prominences. These are very late discoveries. We came to realize this when a spaceship was sent to photograph the sun from a closer distance, and we came to realize that the current sun is not a perfect sphere as it looks to us from standing on the surface of that earth, but it has got these great prominences which indicate the fury of the sun, which indicates the boiling nature of the sun. For the Quran, a book revealed more than 14 centuries ago to an unlettered prophet, peace be upon him, in an unlettered society, to spell out this fact, that precisely is a living testimony that the Quran cannot be the work of man, and is a living testimony to the correct prophethood of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who used to receive that guidance from his creator through Archangel Jibreel. And the second verse after this says, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ, and when the stars will fade out. Nowadays, we know that the degree of luminosity of a star is a great function of the star. The more luminous the star is, the more hot the star is, the more active the star is. And during the phase of dying out of a star, this luminosity fades out gradually. And astronomers came to realize that stars, like any other existing being, existing thing in that universe, has got a birth, a childhood, a youthful stage, a stage of maturity, and old age, and a dying out stage. So one of the main signs of a dying out star is losing its luminosity, fading out. And the Quran is saying here that two of the most important signs of the last hour, the destruction of that universe, will be that the sun will become a perfect sphere, withdrawing its prominences inwardly due to the fading out of the nuclear reaction within its own center, and stars will lose a certain degree or a great degree of their luminosities, and they will fade out gradually. Who would have known this 14 centuries ago other than the Creator himself? Who in the companionship of Muhammad, peace be upon him, would ask about these things? Why did Allah bring these two verses in the Quran unless Allah knows in his eternal knowledge that time will come when man can discover these facts, and these simple two verses can remain a living testimony for the divine nature of the glorious Quran and for the correct prophethood of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Actually, I have excellent illustrations of the sun from a short distance. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is also quoted to have said, "Ash-shamsu wal-qamaru yukawwarani yawm al-qiyamah." The sun and the moon will be made in perfect spheres on the Day of Judgment. And we have seen how the sun, with its great prominences of today, can fade out and can withdraw these prominences inwardly so that it can become a perfect sphere. But the moon is very close to us, and the moon is a perfect sphere. How could we understand this statement by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? Ash-shamsu wal-qamaru yukawwarani yawm al-qiyamah. Ash-shamsu wal-qamaru yukawwarani yawm al-qiyamah. We will have a short break and come back to you to explain this hadith, this saying by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, how we can interpret this hadith in the light of the knowledge of our time. So please wait for us and we'll come back soon. Welcome back, dear viewers. Just before that break, we were mentioning the saying by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he said that the moon and the sun will be made in perfect spheres on the Day of Judgment, or during the last hour, before the Day of Judgment. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said this hadith, but we know that the moon is currently perfectly spherical. The sun has got lots of huge prominences, and we understand that if these prominences are withdrawn to the inner part of the sun, inner core of the sun, then the sun will be a perfect sphere. But why did Muhammad, peace be upon him, say, "Ash-shamsu wal-qamaru yukawwarani yawm al-qiyamah"? Both the sun and the moon will be made in perfect spheres on the day of resurrection or during the last hour. There is a verse in the glorious Quran in Surah Al-Qiyamah that reads, "وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ," when the moon and the sun will be made into a single entity. And it's really amazing for the Quran to speak about this, because this fact was only revealed to scientists a few decades ago, when it was discovered that the moon is drifting away from us at the rate of 3 to 4 centimeters per year. And this was not known except through using very complicated techniques, using laser beams, having a huge mirror placed on top of the moon and measuring the distance of the moon from the Earth very precisely. It was proved that the moon is drifting away from us at the rate of 3 to 4 centimeters per year. This means that time will come when the moon will really escape the gravity of the Earth and enter the gravitational field of the sun and would be completely swallowed by the sun. And if the sun is going to be made into a perfect sphere, the body of the moon would be within the sun and it would also be made into a perfect sphere. We read a third sign of the last hour in Surah Al-Mursalat, where the Quran reads, فَإِذَا النُّجُومُ طُمِسَتْ. فَإِذَا النُّجُومُ طُمِسَتْ. Trees when the stars are completely dimmed. And look at the precision of the description of the successive stages in the destruction of that universe. We first read that the sun is going to be made into a perfect sphere. And only very recently, we came to understand that this can take place through the withdrawal of the solar prominences from its surface inwardly, due to the fading out of the nuclear reaction within the sun. It's really amazing for a book revealed more than 14 centuries ago to an unlettered prophet, peace be upon him, in an unlettered society, to spell out such very precise scientific facts that were only disclosed to the human knowledge in the last few decades of the 20th century. For the Quran to speak about إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ, when the sun is made into a perfect sphere. And we understand today that the solar prominences are in the range of several hundreds of thousands of kilometers. And these reflect the highly boiling nature of the inner core of the sun at a temperature of about 15 million degrees centigrade. If that nuclear reaction within the sun fades out, these prominences will be drawn inwardly, and the sun will take a perfect spherical shape. Then the Quran speaks about وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ, when the moon and the sun will be made into a separate entity. And science proves to us today that the moon is drifting away from the earth at the rate of 3 to 4 centimeters per year. And logic would tell us that time has to come when the moon will escape from the gravity of the earth and will be captured by the gravity of the sun alone, then the sun will swallow it. And if the moon is swallowed by the sun, and the sun was made in a perfect sphere, the material of the moon would be made into a perfect sphere. Then the Quran says, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ, when the stars will fade out. And we came to realize that one of the basic characteristics of stars is the degree of luminosity of the star, which reflects its temperature, chemical composition, mass, speed, and the rest. And if this degree of luminosity fades out, then the star is dying out. And this is a very recent discovery in the area of astronomy. For the Quran to spell it out for more than 14 centuries ago is a living testimony that it cannot be the work of man. And then in Surah Al-Mursalat, we read, فَإِذَا النُّجُومُ طُمِسَتْ, when the stars are completely dimmed. So we have three stages: sphericity, fading out or losing part of luminosity, and then dimming out completely. In the last few decades of the 20th century, giant stars were discovered in our sky that have exploded, leaving behind what astronomers have called black hole. The black hole is an extremely dense body of matter, density, fantastic density. And then because of its great density, great gravity, light cannot be emanated from within it. It's a star, but light cannot escape. It's a great gravity, so nobody can see it. How, and if light falls on it, it's swallowed immediately. These bodies, what were called black holes, were only discovered when we saw that it can swallow any form of matter or energy that enters into its field, its event horizon, the field around it. But for stars that are far away to be swallowed by a black hole, we find rays of electrons being pulled from these stars towards that black spot. So black holes were discovered in the late few decades of the 20th century, 1970s and 1980s. And for the Quran, a book revealed more than 14 centuries ago to an unlettered prophet, peace be upon him, in an unlettered society, to speak about these successive stages in the dying out of a star, taking the shape of a perfect sphere, I mean losing prominences, then dimming out, then finally being completely obscured in the form of black hole, This is a really a living testimony that the Quran cannot be the work of man, because no man at the time of revelation of the glorious Quran knew anything about these things. These are recent discoveries that took place only in the last few decades of the 20th century. We can keep on going with the glorious Quran to see other signs of the last hour, which are numerous actually in the Quran and the Sunnah. One of these signs is وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُرِجَتْ, when the sky will be opened asunder, will be split asunder. Nowadays, we know that the firmament around us is very closely knit by gravity. Every heavenly body is attached to the nearby bodies by gravity. And if this gravity lines are broken, then everything will collapse. And that's why the Quran speaks about إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انشَقَّتْ, when the firmament is going to be broken asunder. إِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُرِجَتْ, when the firmament is going to be opened asunder. إِذَا السَّمَاءُ فُتِحَتْ, فُتِحَتْ السَّمَاءُ فَكَانَتْ أَبْوَابًا, when the sky is going to be opened. Obviously, these are some of the signs of the last hour, the few short spans of time during which the current universe is going to be destroyed, to be replaced by a different earth than ours and a different firmament than the one surrounding us. And after that, of course, there will be resurrection from the new earth, which will include the remnants of our bodies. And this is a miracle by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we'll be resurrected from that new earth. And after resurrection, there will be accountability and judgment, and then eternity in life to come. And that's why the Quran has differentiated between the last hour, between the day of resurrection, and then and judgment, and every other action that will take place during that time. And then moving to another world, there is eternity with no end, either in paradise forever or in hell forever. And because of this, the Quran urges every rational person to work for this eternity, because our life on that planet is a very short period of time. If you live 80 years, 90 years, 100 years, is absolutely nothing compared to eternity in life to come. Of course, we have very many signs for the last hour in the Quran and Sunnah, which cannot be covered completely. I quoted 3 or 4 of them and hope to meet again with you in another episode to spell out the scientific notions in the glorious Quran. And until that time, I leave you in peace. And salute you in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah, peace, blessings, and mercy be with you all.